For coming out to Neshoba Regional High School. My name is Joe McCarthy. I'm the high school band director here. And welcome to our first fall concert of the year for the Neshoba Symphonic Band. This group is a group that we started 7 years ago, I believe now, that consists of high school kids, teachers, community members, parents, anyone really can join. And it's a group that's meant to help enrich the music education for both our students and all of our adult members. So we are really excited to present this particular concert. We've been working really, really hard. Just a couple of quick announcements. First is just be sure to silence all cell phones and things that ring. Secondly, just kind of keep aware of where exits are. I have been asked by the fire department to do that this year, and I forgot at our high school concert on Wednesday. So I'm making it a point this year. We got two fire exits on either side of the stage and in your seats. I had a whole list, and then I forgot what the list was. I don't know. That works. So please welcome Mr. David Bailey, our conductor, and the Neshoba the Neshoba Symphonic Band.
Thank you. That was a little Shostakovich. Actually, there's no such thing as a little Shostakovich. This was a great piece. The fun thing about the Shostakovich is that he'd had it hidden in a drawer for all the time that he was putting up with that wonderful gentleman, Stalin. He was hiding things from him. He was one of the few Soviet composers that didn't just escape. I mean, people like Rachmaninoff and some others just jumped ship when they well should have. But he sort of held out. And so anyway, he did this glorious thing that had been hiding in his bottom desk drawer for many years. This wonderful festival literature, one of my favorites and one of the staples of the band literature. We're going to move on to, I wanted to speak just half a second about our theme for the year. When we're talking, the theme for the year is joy and form, and probably looking at that on the posters and things, joy and form, what does that mean? Well, we're looking at the different ways that music is kind of put together. In this first one, we're talking about the exposition, which is the main theme of a piece, and just how it's taken and the main kinds of forms that show up all during music. This, for instance, the overture that we just played goes back to one of the earliest forms that we have, first of all in Greek spoken drama, but then in early Renaissance and medieval music, where you have a slow introduction, a really fast section, and a slow ending. So it's all just we're playing with some of the basics this year, and that's what the title means. Exposition is the main theme. So all of these, just about everything we play today has an outstanding sort of hummable tune that you can walk away with. The second piece, the Suite from Candide. I don't know how many of you are familiar with the opera itself, but it's a wonderful setting of Voltaire's story, which in itself is really, really, really fun to read and very funny. If we look at our theme for the year, though, it's in a suite, and one of the earliest forms of forms was the dance suite. And if you look at each one of these movements, it was selected because not only because it fits with the show, the different parts of the show. I hope that you've had time to take a look at the notes. It tells you a little bit about that. But because it's also in the form of a Renaissance dance suite. So you have fast, slow, fast, then a different fast, and then and the Renaissance dance suite would be a slow dance and then a quick dance, and it all, as we go down through time, it ended up being what we look at as our modern forms of like the quartet and the symphony and the sonata. And even sets of dances that we do, sets of square dancing and things like that, where you have contrasting folk dances, contrasting dances. So we think you'll enjoy this suite from Candide. It's one of my favorites. And Bernstein collaborated some with Claire Grundman before he died on how to put together a suite that would keep his music sort of in its having its original feeling, in the way that Bernstein wrote it, which is very unique. So anyway, here's the Candide Suite by Claire Grundman. Thank you. We are going to take a brief intermission. I think that there's some goodies out in the hallway, but it's going to be about 10 minutes, just long enough for us to regroup before we do the wonderful Giannini Symphony No. 3. Thank you. All right. Just briefly before we start the next half, a couple of people I would like to thank. First of all, I want to thank the Neshoba Regional High School Friends of Music for all of their support and everything that they do to take care of us. And I'd like to thank a couple of other people that we couldn't do things without. The stuff doesn't just get moved around on its own. We don't like to shut the doors at night and the fairies and the elves come around and move heavy stuff around. I've got a couple of wonderful people helping me out. Logan and Jill that are up here come every Thursday and just help me shove all of this stuff over from the band room and onto stage. And we couldn't do it without those two. So let's give them a hand. And by the same token, the music doesn't just kind of show up. So Alyssa over here is my librarian this year. So let's give her a hand. And finally, somebody that we really can't do without is the person doing the lighting and the sound. And you never quite give them enough credit for everything that they do because it all seems like it's behind the scenes. And that just sort of magically happens too. So I want to thank Remy Sumner for her help in that. So thank you. And more than anyone else, I want to thank my sort of colleague and mentor and help me out in everything and out of everything sort of thing, Joe McCarthy. So it's a pleasure. This is my seventh year here at the school. We started the symphonic band up here, and it's grown and grown and grown, and I've taken on more and more responsibilities here at the high school because someone would say, you don't know how to play piano, do you? And I go, I don't know why. You know. And so I've been the accompanist here for 7 years. This is my seventh year doing that too. And I've become part of the family. I feel like I'm part of the family here at Neshoba Regional, and it's a great thing. And further, this goes with what Joe said earlier, this band is family too because of the way it's structured. Well, structured is even a bad word because I don't really like to think of it as structure. We're colleagues up here, and it's everyone. We have students starting around 14. And going up to some of the older, we've had people up in their 80s in the band, and so it spans like four generations. And it's a wonderful thing to be able to all sit down together and make music and do some positive things in the world, you know, this crazy place. And it's a positive thing that no matter what, this is good stuff. And it's sharing between generations. And it's a part of my life that I think it's the best time in my life so far, and I'm in my 70s, and this is like the best, as they say, the best gig I've ever had. and it's true because it's one big family here that we care about each other, and we get to make music, we get to touch creation together, we get to touch the infinite. You figure that we're looking at notes on a page, and somehow it magically, that is magic. The stands and the chairs don't get here magically. Music doesn't get it put out magically. The lights aren't magic. But the creation of music and sharing it, that's magic. We're going to play for you one of the first really, really important works for concert band by Vittorio Giannini. Writes in the Italian-American style, and this is a symphony that he wrote specifically for band. And we think you'll enjoy it. I think it's the first actual full symphony that was written for band. And we're gonna start a cycle tonight of three or four of them that should be done. And this is Vittorio Giannini's Symphony for Band. Thank you. Once again, we'd like to thank everyone for coming this afternoon. We'd like to conclude this afternoon's program with a circus tune. It's not a march, it's a kind of a ragtime clown piece, a one-step, which was kind of a walk around and where you just sort of walked around in ragtime rhythm. You see also several different kinds of steps that are done with it, so it's not specific. The next concert is, I want to say, February the 6th. You can check your calendar there. This is the 150th anniversary of the birth of the composer Ralph Vaughan Williams, and in sort of keeping with sort of a worldwide celebration, we're going to be playing his Variations for Wind Band, which is a really, really nice piece. So that's on the program. And some other good stuff, some other fun stuff for February. So keep that on your calendar, and we'll keep in touch. Right here is, we're going to end with the Broadway One Step by the wonderful, wonderful circus composer, Carl King. Thank you. We'll see you in February. I wish we had another one, but thank you so much for coming. Have a great weekend.